Hello, my name is Julian Dietke and I present you Ordinos. It is joint work with Ralf Küsters, Johannes Müller, Daniel Rausch and Andreas Vogt. Ordinos is the first provable, secure, verifiable, tele-hiding remote e-voting system. Let us briefly discuss what these properties are. Verifiability means that parties are able to check whether the claimed result of the election is correct. This check can be performed by individual voters, but it is not restricted to participants of the voting protocol. Thus, everyone can verify the election result. The next property I want to talk about is telehiding. In order to explain what telehiding is, let me first give you an intuition on how traditional e-voting systems and paper-based elections work. I will roughly go over a typical voting flow. We have a set of voters, cast their votes, and send them to the bulletin board. Then the votes are counted. The result of this is what we call the full tally. Typically, in traditional votings, the full tally is revealed. Now, everyone is able to compute the election result. For example, which candidate received the most votes, based on the full tally. Often, the voting result consists of a single winner, or a ranking of candidates. So, revealing only this information, but not the full tally, is sufficient. Thus, this voting flow reveals more information than necessary. In case of traditional voting, publishing the full tally is done in order to obtain verifiability. But revealing the full tally has several downsides. For example, in some elections, like within companies, student associations, or in boardroom elections, it might be embarrassing for the losing candidate to publish the possibly low number of votes they received. Additionally, publishing the full tally lowers the privacy of the voters. For example, elections are often carried out among a small set of voters, like in boardroom or jury votings. Revealing the full tally in such a setting leads to a low level of privacy, because the vote of a single voter is only hidden behind a low number of other votes. For voting methods that allow to cast more complex ballots, for example like ranking-based votings, publishing the full tally leads to a low level of privacy in general. This is because the total number of possible choices typically increases exponentially in the number of candidates. Therefore, the individual choices of the voters can be essentially unique, even if the number of candidates is moderate. This privacy loss can be used by an adversary to perform so-called Italian attacks. He can coerce a voter to vote in a specific, unlikely way and then use the full tally to check whether the voter complied. Moreover, some elections have several rounds. In particular, they might involve runoff elections. In order to get unbiased voters' opinions, one might not want to reveal intermediate election tallies, except for the information which candidates move on to the next election round. These examples illustrate that, for some situations, it is desirable to not publish the full tally as part of the tallying procedure, but to only publish the election result, like only the winner of an election, without the exact vote counts. We call this concept tele-hiding, and it works as follows. In tele-hiding e-voting, we only reveal the election result in which we are interested. In particular, full tally is not revealed. The concept of tele-hiding has many use cases. As presented before, there are several downsides of revealing the full tally. Because of this, there are associations that do not publish the full tally for exact this reason. But what about verifiability? How can we verify that the election result is correct if we do not see the full tally? Can we verify the result, hence trust the result? The answer is yes, we can. On the one hand, we have verifiability, and on the other hand, we have tally hiding, where we only want to reveal the election result. With ordinals, we combine both of these properties. Ordinals is the first provable secure, verifiable, and tally hiding e-voting system. Therefore, ordinals opens completely new possibilities for votings, because it allows for elections that cannot be done with traditional e-voting schemes or traditional paper-based votings. Let me briefly present you the workflow of ordinals. On a high level, ordinals strictly extends Helios and works as follows. As usually done, the voters cast encrypted votes. Next, the votes are homomorphically aggregated in order to obtain the full tally. Note that the full tally is encrypted. In traditional e-voting systems, like Helios, the next step is to decrypt the full tally. Here, ordinals starts to make things differently. Instead of revealing the full tally, the encrypted tally is sent as an input to an MPC component. This MPC component is run among the trustees of the election and computes the specific election result. Then, only the result of the MPC component, namely the election result, published. For ordinals, we need an MPC component with properties that are suitable for our e-voting scenario. Firstly, the security properties should be guaranteed even if all computing parties are malicious. Secondly, correctness of the computation must be publicly verifiable so that every external observer, not only the computing parties, can check that the election outcome is valid. Thirdly, we require accountability. Accountability guarantees that if the published election result does not match how the voters actually voted, then this is not only detected, as required for verifiability, but misbehaving parties can even be identified and blamed for the misbehavior. In order to provide accountability, the MPC protocol must provide identifiable abort. Fourthly, the MPC protocol has to fit to the client-server model in which the input parties, namely the voters, are not required to actively participate in computing the result. Unfortunately, typical MPC protocols do not offer all of these properties. Thus, there's no plug-and-play solution for our setting. So what we did is, we constructed several suitable MPC protocols supporting various result functions. The MPC protocols are based on the equality and gradadent tests by Lipma and Toft. We even implemented the ordinal system and showed that it is practical. The first plot demonstrates that running time is independent of any specific number of voters. The next plot shows that ordinals is practical for even 40 candidates, independently of whether the implementation runs over a local network or the internet. The determining factor in terms of performance is the number of candidates. So let me do a quick recap. I presented you ordinals, which is the first provable, secure, verifiable, and tally-hiding e-voting system. With that, it allows for new options in voting, which simply weren't possible before. In the future, we want to extend ordinals to support even larger number of candidates and support more complex result functions. And with that, I conclude my talk and want to thank you for your attention.